both openings were pretty good. Did a very good job. John, explain what preponderance of the evidence means when you mention it in your opening, because I didn't know what it meant. At least from the point of being an unsophisticated juror. Michelle, is it Michelle? Or,
yeah.
Okay. Do you see the defendant in court today is not the same as do you see Avery Bancroft today? At least not in my mind, because you want them to identify Avery Bancroft, and if that's not Avery Bancroft, it's still the defendant. You know what I mean? So just use your
honor coats.
Oh yeah, it is in another building.
What a man.
It was cold out there.
Devin, well, actually the old defense. I know these rooms are kind of a little awkward for crossing, but you needed to still stand closer to the witness than what you actually did. So just keep that in mind if you come across a room like this, like regional or something. Just try to pick out a spot beforehand and say, okay, this is the least awkward place that we can do this and still have it be okay. Ryan, watch your left hand being up the entire time during the rec. It never went down. It was kind of distracting for me. It's just one of those things that, you know, presentation-wise, I think you can get rid of like overnight and stuff. It's not huge deal. Basically the entire defense team, it makes it hard for me to grade you well when you're using notes because they're not using notes, and it's not fair for me to give the two of you similar scores if they can do it from memory, you know what I mean? So that's one of the things where real world and mock trial differ is real world you can use, you know, notes, but in mock trial you really want to go memorize so you can get over that. Similarly, prosecution, it's hard for me to give you really good scores if you're spending their entire case in chief or your entire case in chief looking over your stuff before you give it. You really want to be paying attention the entire time. That's something that'll set you apart at regionals if you're paying attention the entire time and have to memorize. Just witnesses in general today, I think we needed to get more character out as well. But you know, that's, you want to go, so everything before regionals is preseason. So you want to go over the top as possible because it's easier to bring it back down than it is to take it back up. So just go crazy and then see what judges like and don't like. Defense witnesses, you did a pretty good job of not really finding anything on cross, which made me believe you more. Specifically, Lorian, you did a really good job of admitting to things but then not letting them twist your words, which was really good. Defense, your directs were fairly short though, which makes it hard for me again to evaluate your witnesses because we get to see them for such a short amount of time, I can't really see their character come out. So you really want to try to lengthen those out a little bit, just, you know, at least for the sake of your witnesses. Michelle, again, good job and good passion arguing. That was really good. You had very good attorney presence all day.
Thank you.
You were very passionate. You did a really good job.
Thank you.
The 8033 objection got me, so if I was wrong, my bad. So I just went with you because you cited a rule and let that be a lesson. Mock trial judges don't know everything, so if you can cite a rule and do it confidently, they might side with you. For both sides, we need to bring out your theme a little bit more during the case. I totally forgot what they were until we got to closings, and you don't want that to happen because your theme is what you want the judges slash jury to remember throughout so that they can think of, oh, okay, that's what we stand for. Loved the tennis analogy, loved it, it was great. Made complete sense, good job with that. And also good job on excluding Chase Covington from the entrapment thing, but you should do that in the main body of your closing, and if you did, I didn't hear it.
Well, it was more of like a waiting to see if they did it, because I didn't really hear it on the Bancroft direct at all.
Gotcha. I would still bring it in just in case, that way you're not left at the end like, oh,
yeah.
Here's this magical solution that makes it better for us, you know what I mean? Michelle, your opening just got a little too argumentative at the end, but otherwise it was really good.
Thank you.
Everyone needs to stand up when talking to the judge and receiving evidence. I don't know of any specific instance where that happened, but just
defense, don't, I wouldn't object to the, I wouldn't waive your objection to the evidence when they show it to you. I would object when they move to admit it into evidence. That way, if something funky goes wrong while the witness is testifying about it, then you can make an objection or something like that. And that way, we don't kind of, and that's just kind of how the norm is in mock trial, and that way you don't just be confused with the judge. That's all I got.
All right, well, like he said, I feel like both of you did a really good job. When you look at my comment sheets, if you do, you'll see there's mostly polishing sort of things. Some things I kind of was repetitive on what he was saying would be kind of where you are in the courtroom. You want to know how close you are to the judges and the jury so that way you can watch how loud you are. Because sometimes it can be overbearing, like Michelle. Sometimes your voice carries.
I know.
A lot. And it's great because it's clear, but sometimes it can be just much coming on because if I'm not paying attention or I'm off, it wakes me up, which is good. But if it's a point you're trying to get out of, you don't want to draw too much attention to it. Other things, kind of like you said, with witnesses, you want to watch how argumentative you're being, especially if you're an expert witness. You're being paid to be here. You're only here to state facts that you found or that was given to you. You really don't have a stake in the case, so you don't care how it comes out. Like, one of you was hired by both sides, so what does it matter to you if he's right or if he's wrong about something? Just kind of state it, go off. Like I said, if it's something or he's twisting your words, clarify that. But outside of that, yes, no, and be done with it. That's pretty much all I have, because anything like else would be
You guys have any questions for us?
Yes.
I know you mentioned something about more character coming out. As far as expert witnesses, would you like more character in expert witnesses as well? Or
I thought you could have gotten angrier when you were talking about the police guidelines and how they violated them, because that's your profession.
Okay.
You want to see that happen. So I think, like, if you're going to be passionate about something, that's the time to be passionate.
That makes sense.
And I think that's where your character comes out.
Okay.
Any other?
Would you be all right with this coming up for individual comments?
Yeah, that's fine.